Good news for car buyers looking to bring home an electric vehicle. President Marcos issued Executive Order No. 12 modifying import duty rates on electric vehicles. The EO cuts to zero with a 5% to 7% tariff on EVs, their parts and components. The order covers various vehicles, motorcycles and scooters, but hybrid vehicles are excluded. Marcos says this would protect the Philippines' energy security by reducing reliance on imported fuel.
Philippine Finance Secretary Benjamin Jokno denies an investigative report which claims the Marcos Jr. delegation to the Davos Forum outnumbers those sent by wealthier countries. Jokno says several businessmen were included in the trip because their participation is necessary. The Philippine Presidential Palace says 17 people are part of the official delegation. Well, let's clarify that only 11 administration officials were registered as participants at the Davos Forum.
Philippine President Marcos Jr. says he's not interested in keeping pace with the arms buildup of other countries like Japan. He told the president of the World Economic Forum that the Philippines cannot compete with the defense spending of military giants such as the U.S. and China. Marcos Jr. also said war is not the solution to any disputes in the Southeast Asia region. The Marcos Jr. administration has pushed for the modernization of the Philippine military. Congress has given the Armed Forces Modernization Program a higher 2023 budget of 45 billion pesos, or over 280 million U.S. dollars.
If they are going to be military, then they are not solutions, because it will end badly. If it goes that way, it will end badly for everyone involved. And when I say that, I'm thinking of the war in Ukraine. If a similar situation would arise in the region, then it would be, actually, I would say it would be disastrous for the rest of the world as well. Not only for the region, but for the rest of the world.
President Marcos Jr. tells participants at the World Economic Forum the Philippines can resist the impact of any global recession. But he says this depends on keeping a low jobless rate in the country. Marcos Jr. touted the young Philippine workforce and the need to continuously upgrade their skills.
We have the youngest workforce in Asia. You might be surprised to learn that the average age of a Filipino worker is 23 and a half years old. So that is a huge demographic dividend. But demographic dividend is not paid out just as a matter of course. You have to develop. You have to develop. Now, our workforce is well-trained, our workforce is sophisticated, very English-speaking, in terms of technology, I would say that we are on equal footing as any other, countries.
And cheaper onions are being sold at so-called Kadiwa stores in the Philippines amid a supposed onion crisis. Let's get details from our correspondent, Jose Carretero. Good morning, Jose. Over to you.
Good morning, Nikki. Supplies of red onions continue to arrive here at the Kadiwa store of the Department of Agriculture along Elliptical Road in Quezon City. These red onions came from Ilocos Norte and Pangasinan. But compared to the regular onions, the onions that arrived today are a bit smaller. They call it dried lasona, and it's being sold at 170 pesos per kilo. There are fresh lasona also from Pangasinan, which they sell at 150 pesos per kilo. The supply of fresh lasona that arrived today is 1,500 kilos and will be distributed in Kadiwa stores in Metro Manila. Early this morning, some onions were brought to Kadiwa stores in Pasig and in San Juan. Onion vendors are hoping prices of red onions will go down as some farmers have already started harvesting, particularly in Ilocos region. Meanwhile, aside from cheaper red onions, consumers can buy also eggs a bit cheaper compared to prices of eggs in the market. Most of the onions being sold in the Kadiwa store came from the north, especially from Pangasinan and some parts of Ilocos. Meanwhile, going back to the prices of eggs, Nikki, large size of egg is sold at 8 pesos, while the smaller size is sold at 750 pesos. There are cheaper vegetables also at the Kadiwa stores. Miki.
And Jose, any updates on those that are imported concerning onions?
Come again, Miki.
Any updates on those imported concerning onions?
Actually, Miki, The Department of Agriculture is still waiting for the imported onions to arrive. And they also warn consumers not to buy imported onions being sold in some public market here in Metro Manila because that's smuggled onions, mm-hmm. according to the Department of Agriculture.
All right. Thanks for that update, Jose. Stacey?